All right, let's take you back out to the launch pad. Boeing Starliner is in the final stages of preps for its test mission up to the International Space Station tomorrow.
West 2 Space Coast Bureau Chief Scott Heidler is live at Kennedy Space Center. And Scott, it seems there's confidence the issues from the scrub are fixed and it's good to go.
Yes, exactly that. You know, everything is polling at this stage go. You know, there was a mission management briefing here just in the last few hours, and they're saying everything from the rocket to the spacecraft to the weather, Starliner is ready to fly. The Starliner spacecraft named Calypso atop a ULA Atlas V rocket assumed the position yet again on Launch Complex 41 at the Cape Canaveral Space Force Station. The crew, two seasoned NASA astronauts despite the delays, ready for launch.
I personally don't feel its jitters. I just feel like I'm excited to share this opportunity with my friends and family who are coming in a day or two. And I think that's what is actually really making me a little bit nervous. I'm just excited for them to be here.
We've got our fingerprints on every single procedure that exists for this spacecraft. And that's part of what the test process is. It's test and development.
Here they come, our CFT crew.
After years of delays in the Starliner program, the first human test flight attempt on May 6th was scrubbed.
The vehicle is not in a configuration where we can proceed.
A helium leak the cause. It's been fixed. Teams keeping a close eye on what could have caused it and if the leak rate increases. But teams also working through other changes like the need for a cargo swap out.
I think what I've seen out of the Boeing and NASA team and the ULA team working with our space station team is a lot of agility in the last week at dealing with these things as they come up, which tells me that we're really ready to go fly.
Launch countdown is set to start in the pre-dawn hours of Saturday as Boeing and NASA hope to bring in another way for astronauts to get to low Earth orbit from American soil. Joining SpaceX's Crew Dragon already in the game for 4 years.
In the end, we're still going to need to have the ability to bring astronauts to space stations in the future. And so I'm sure that Boeing would like to get a share of that work too.
But ahead of all that, Starliner needs to be certified to carry humans. And the next step in that process launches from here tomorrow afternoon at 12:25. Reporting live at the Kennedy Space Center, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.
And again, that launch is set for 12:25 tomorrow. We will have live team coverage right here on West 2 in the minutes leading up to the launch until the astronauts are in orbit.